If you are using GLP-1 medication like Ozempic or Wegovy or Zepbound or Mounjaro, you probably wondered, am I on the right dose? Should I increase? Should I stay where I am? Hi, I'm Dr. Bazgha Khalid. I am an internal medicine and obesity medicine board certified doctor, and I have been prescribing GLP-1 medications for diabetes and weight loss since their FDA approval. Today, I'm breaking it all down. What GLP-1 medications are, how they work, the role of dose titration, and most importantly, how to figure out the dose that's right for you. Let's dive in. So what are the GLP-1 medications? GLP-1 medications were originally approved for type 2 diabetes, but now they are widely used for weight loss and weight loss maintenance. Common names for GLP-1 medications are Semaglutide under brand name Ozempic for diabetes and Wegovy for weight loss. And the other commonly used GLP-1 medication is Tirzepatide under brand name of Zepbound for weight loss and Mounjaro for diabetes. GLP-1 medications mimic a natural hormone in the body called GLP-1, glucagon-like peptide 1. That helps control blood sugar, reduces appetite, and slows digestion. Let's talk about GLP-1 medications' mechanism of action. GLP-1 medications slow down stomach emptying, therefore you feel full longer. GLP-1 medications talk to your brain's appetite center and reduce cravings. GLP-1 medications improve blood sugar control by helping insulin work better. The end result using GLP-1 medications is less hunger, smaller portions, better blood sugar control, and weight loss. So what are the FDA-approved uses of GLP-1 medications? GLP-1 medications are FDA-approved for weight loss in people with obesity or overweight with weight-related comorbid health condition. They're also approved for management of type 2 diabetes, for reduction of major cardiovascular risk events in high-risk patients, obstructive sleep apnea. Zepbound is FDA approved for obstructive sleep apnea. Let's review common side effects of GLP-1 medications: nausea, vomiting, constipation, fatigue, bloating, headaches, dehydration, constipation. Sometimes more serious side effects like gastroparesis, which is slowing of the stomach, gallbladder issues, pancreatic inflammation. I have a video called Everything You Need to Know About Zepbound. I'll post the link in the description below. Do check it out. Now, most GLP-1 medication side effects are dose related, which is why titration matters. So what is the dose titration? Dose titration is slowly adjusting the GLP-1 medication dose over weeks to balance effectiveness and tolerance. The goal for dose titration is to reach a dose where you lose weight and feel well without overwhelming side effects. Let's talk about examples of dose titration. Let's start with Zepbound or Tirzepatide dose titration. The starting dose of Zepbound is 2.5 milligrams once weekly for 4 weeks. Starting dose is just to get your body used to the medicine. Then we usually move to the 5 milligram once weekly for 4 weeks. Then we increase every 4 weeks if needed and tolerated. We move to 7.5 milligram weekly, then to 10 milligram, and then to 12.5 milligram weekly, then 15 milligram weekly. Now 15 milligram is the maximum dose for Zepbound. For dose titration for Wegovy or Semaglutide, we start Wegovy at 0.25 milligram weekly for 4 weeks, then move to 0.5 milligram weekly, then 1 milligram, 1.7 milligram. The maximum dose of Wegovy is 2.4 milligram. Big question is how and when to up titrate GLP-1 medication dose. Here is the rule of thumb. Move up the medication dose only if you have been on the current dose for at least 4 weeks, you are tolerating the current dose with no to minimal side effects, and number three, you're not getting enough appetite control or weight loss at the current dose. Ideally, you should meet all three criteria to consider dose up titration. Let's take an example. you were started on Zepbound, 2.5 milligram weekly, which is the starting dose, and moved up to 5 milligram on your 1 month follow-up appointment. Now you are on the Zepbound 5 milligram 4 weeks already and come for another follow-up appointment and still experience feeling very hungry, but you're tolerating the current dose of 5 milligram Zepbound well with no side effects, then moving to 7.5 milligram weekly may help. Now remember, in this case, you meet all three criteria. You've been on Zepbound 5 milligram weekly for 4 weeks, you're tolerating it well with no side effects, and you are not experiencing appetite suppression or weight loss on current dose. So titrating up will help. Similarly, let's say if you're on Wegovy 0.5 milligram weekly and still snacking often and not seeing any weight loss on current dose. However, you're tolerating the 0.5 milligram dose well with no nausea or other significant side effects, then it's safe to increase Wegovy to 1 milligram weekly. When to pause or stop titration? Consider to pause titration if you are experiencing nausea, vomiting, or stomach upset. Stay at the current dose until symptoms settle down, or you may need to go down titrate if you continue to not tolerate the current dose. Stop titration if you reach a dose where weight loss is steady and you are comfortable. You don't have to push to the maximum dose. Your best dose is the one you can stay on long term. Now, when to down titrate GLP-1 medication dose? If side effects become unmanageable, like persistent nausea, vomiting, fatigue, severe constipation, then it's better to go back down one dose. Let's say if you are on 10 milligram of Zepbound and having difficulty tolerating it due to significant side effects, then it's best to down titrate and go back to 7.5 milligram weekly dose. Or let's say if you are on 1.7 milligram Wegovy weekly with severe nausea, vomiting, dehydration, or other significant side effects, then dropping back to 1 milligram is reasonable. So what is the maintenance dose for GLP-1 medications? The maintenance dose is the lowest dose where you continue to see benefits without side effects. For some people, the maintenance dose is the maximum dose, like 15 milligram for Zepbound or 2.4 milligram for Wegovy. For others, the maintenance dose might be a lower dose, like 5 milligram of Zepbound or 1.7 milligram of Wegovy. Everyone's body is different. Everybody's response to GLP-1 medications is different as well. Therefore, the right dose is personalized. So what are the FDA-approved maintenance doses for Zepbound? FDA-approved maintenance doses, 5 milligram, 10 milligram, or 15 milligram. So your maintenance dose will be the lowest dose out of these, where you continue to see benefits of ongoing weight loss if still not at goal weight, or weight maintenance without side effects. The maintenance dose for Wegovy is 2.4 milligram weekly. However, if 2.4 milligram weekly is not tolerated, then your doctor may use 1.7 milligram weekly as a maintenance dose. Key takeaways are GLP-1 medication dose is not one size fits all. Titration helps your body adapt and reduce side effects. The right dose is based on effectiveness and tolerability. The maintenance doses may be mid-range or maximum dose of Zepbound or Wegovy. It's about what works for you. Always adjust doses with your doctor's guidance. Finding the right dose of GLP-1 medications is a journey, not a race. The best dose is the one that gives you results while keeping you comfortable and safe. If you found this breakdown helpful, hit like, share with someone starting their GLP-1 journey, and subscribe for more science-backed, easy-to-understand weight loss guidance. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.